great things in the industry for a number of years. Let's bring up Mr. Kurt Wheeler.
I'm supposed to be up here talking. It's time about half. Okay. All right, wait, real quick. Okay, we teach the biblical concept. So, you know, we're going to tell you, I'm up here supposed to be talking about event prospecting. Now, I look like this. Every time I walk out of my house, it's an event, because I'm always prospecting. That's just me. But listen, we're going to say, you know, back in Matthew 4:19, I think, when Jesus was walking along the shore of Galilee, right? And he came across, and he's banning his business, and he's coming across. He came across Andrew and Simon. What were they doing? They were in the boat working their business, their mighty kind of business, right? They working their business. They were getting nowhere. Because they didn't know how to prospect. Right? So Jesus said, drop that stuff. Drop it. And come follow me. I'm going to teach you. Then they kept on walking along the shore, right? They came across with the two brothers, John and James. And then their father in the boat, too. Then they working their mighty kind of business. Didn't know what they were doing. Drop that stuff. Come follow me. I'm going to teach you. So as they kept walking, they teach you. And remember, he's going to be sending them out there, training them to go out there and market their business. We're going to be fisher of men. So that's what we're going to all be in here, fisher of men and women for the business. So when you're prospecting, first of all, it's personable. I like to say, this business is a personable business. You know, there's other ways to do prospecting. Like you said, we talked about social media. What was the other one? We talked about brochures and business cards. But I believe in this network marketing industry, you know, it's a personal thing, because people don't join the business, right? They join you.
Absolutely.
So you have to make them feel like you understand and you feel the exact same pain they feel. So you have to get what we call, you know, there's a term we use in the industry itself, you know, that form. Everybody heard of form, right?
Right.
Now you want to find out their feelings. You want to get them, because no matter how they feel, you feel the exact same way. No matter. So I'm going to talk about your family first. I'm going to meet you out here on the street, because I can be at the gas station, Walmart, Lowe's. This is event prospecting, so I'm at a youth convention. I'm over at a flea market. I'm at a women's empowerment event. I'm wherever. But I'm going to go out there, and I'm going to meet you. And I've never met a stranger. Me being an ex-Navy recruiter, I can talk to a wall. And then we join the military. We ready. I'll put you in there. Okay, but see, you're gonna get to understand people. You're gonna get to meet people, and they have to feel comfortable with you, so they'll join your business. Because remember, they know nothing about my econ. They know nothing about the industry, but they know you once you become personable with them. Right? So we're gonna talk about the family, the occupation, recreation, and I promise you, within 3 to 5 minutes of talking to people, it's gonna come back to money some situation somehow. Something's gonna lead into money. That's your option. That's your way in. But you have to listen. You know, you have to, like I said, the last one who speaks loses. Right? So, well, no, the first one who speaks loses, really. So you have to, like, you're good out there, meet people, you know, talk about them, get them comfortable with you, and then slide your way. It's just like evangelism. You know, you don't just rush up to somebody and say, hey, I want you, let's talk about Jesus. But you're going to talk about, you know, what they talk about. And you slide into evangelism. And before they know it, they're at your church. Right? You know, so it's people join you. So we're going to be out there prospecting with people, and we're going to be talking with them, finding out, you know, what they do, how many children they have, what they do for recreation, you know, how, you know, their life story. And then you're going to ask them a question. You know, you're going to ask them, what if I can show you something to alleviate that pain? Because I'm all about, like I say, this is a personable business. I'm all about being able to relate to somebody to get them. Because if I can get them to relate, you know, if I can relate to them and get them to understand their situation, like you said, you know, people won't do this business if they don't understand the business. So if I can get them to relate to their pain, where they are, they meet them where they are, and let them understand, they'll take the business seriously. So when you're talking with people, when you're out there meeting them, you find out what they like, what their intentions are, what are their long-term goals, what are their short-term goals. You know, how to get there, because everything we have in this business will get them to where they want to be. I've had people tell me all the time, you know, sometimes, well, I just can't see myself doing that all my life. I didn't say do it in your life. I said use it as a vehicle to get where you want to be. I think this is so talked on that a little bit. You know, we can use this industry to get where you want to be. Your ultimate goal is to be a decorator or a cake planner or whatever. Use the money here to get there. So when I'm out there prospecting with people, I'm listening to them, what are their goals? You know, and that leads me into just a regular conversation. And that's all prospecting is a conversation. You have to be personable. So when we're on social media, dropping nuggets, because I've been doing this a while and I've made a lot of money. But when I'm doing this, nobody ever really joined my business from day one. I'll put out stuff, I'll plant seeds. You know, and then people will come back and say, hey, I've been following you for 3, 4, 6 months. What is this thing you keep talking about? Because if they don't see you talking about it, if you're not prospecting and continue to follow her, like she said, Mr. Sam had been kept her on a short lease and was talking with her, they'll say, well, you weren't serious about it. Because people, first of all, want to see how serious you are about your business and how it's affecting your life. People love to see having fun with your family and making money. Because that's what drives them. They say, well, I want to be like that. I want to have fun. I want to make money. I love to be with my family out on vacation. So if you can show that to them and in your prospecting, talking with them with this joy, and you have to have that joy in your talk. You have to have that joy in your talk when you're speaking to people. Because if you're just saying, well, I got this business, you know, and it does this, that, and the other. They're asleep while you're talking. They're thinking about what they're ready to do 5, 10 minutes later. But if you're excited about what you do, excited about your business, and you feel that excitement in your own soul, it's gonna roll out. You know. So people join you. So when you're out prospecting, you just strike up a conversation. And you know, a lot of people say, you know, my family, my friends won't. They probably won't. I don't have any family members in my business other than my wife. And she was reluctant at first. That's a different story. So we got, but anyway, she sees now with the money, so we good now, right? We good. But anyway, you know, you talk to people in the streets, you find out their story, you find out what they like, you find out what their goals are, you find out what their objections are, and you suddenly overcome them, you know, and let them see the joy in your spirit, what you're doing. And they tell me I got 1 minute. But I was giving this up. But anyway, you want to get to people, and you want to be out there talking with them. It's a simple conversation with people. But they have to feel it in you. They have to feel my kind in you. And if my kind is not down in your spirit, not down in your soul, it's going to show. And people are not going to join my kind if they can't join you personally. That's my time. I appreciate it. Y'all have a great day.